Xemnas was finally defeated. But after the battle, Sora and Riku found themselves trapped in the Realm of Darkness. Suddenly, a bottle washed up on shore. The message inside led them back to the Realm of Light. strange entry was found in the journal that chronicled Sora's adventures. To investigate, the journal was converted to data, but it was full of bugs. Mickey called on Data Sora to help them restore the world inside the journal. As he restored the datascape, more and more strange messages kept appearing. Mickey and the others should have been watching from the other side of the screen, but somewhere along the way, Data Riku, the embodiment of the journal, had imported them into the datascape to help solve the mystery of the message. Maleficent and Pete were causing all sorts of trouble with their plan to take over the real world through the datascape. Data Sora drew power from the connections with his friends in his heart and used it to fight and forge a path forward. He defeated Sora's Heartless, the bug in the data that had corrupted the journal. That should have been the end of this journey, but Mickey received word that a door to a new world had appeared, and he once again entered the datascape. On the other side of the door was Castle Oblivion. Led by a figure in black, Data Sora repeatedly relived the pain residing in his heart. If he kept holding on to that hurt, he would be dragged down into the darkness. But Data Sora realized that his pain was what tied his memories together. He swore to the cloaked figure, Roxas, that he accepted the pain. The hurt of those connected to Sora remained dormant in his heart. And to help find a way to face and heal that pain, Naminé had left the mysterious journal entry. Their hurting will be mended when you return to end it. Mickey and Data Sora now knew the true meaning of those words. Data Sora thanked Naminé, and they said their goodbyes. Mickey wrote Sora a letter detailing the events that took place in the datascape. You are who you are because of those people. They need you, and now the door to your next journey is ready to be opened. Master Ericus's three apprentices affirmed their bonds of friendship as they prepared for the Mark of Mastery exam. But Aqua was the only one to pass the exam and become a Keyblade Master. Leaving Terra no time for disappointment, the three immediately received word that creatures called the Unversed had emerged to threaten the World of Light, and Master Xehanort had gone missing. Both Terra and Aqua were tasked with bringing the situation under control. Meanwhile, a masked boy left Ventus with a distressing thought. Terra resisted the call of darkness as he sought out Xehanort and the Unversed. Ventus chased after him, and Aqua carried out orders to monitor Terra. Everything was going perfectly according to Master Xehanort's plan. It turns out that when I was little, Aqua came to my rescue in Radiant Garden. Then she reunited with Terra and Ventus, but once again, their paths and hearts quickly diverged. Terra was guided by a light to a young boy, Riku. He bequeathed Riku his Keyblade. Meanwhile, Ventus learned he would become the Keyblade, and Master Ericus tried to seal him away. Determined to save his friend, Terra unleashed the power of darkness as he faced his own master. The Keyblade would form when pure light and pure darkness clashed. Ventus set out toward the Keyblade graveyard to bring all of this to an end.